We get all space cowboy in this VFX breakdown. Welcome to VFX Breakdown, the show where we show you how to do your favorite visual effects from TV and film. 2021 brought us the arrival and the very quick departure of the highly anticipated Netflix anime adaptation series, Cowboy Bebop. Now, whereas the acting and the scripting were a little bit less than memorable, we actually found some visual effects that we kind of liked. Like this one from the Lost Session teaser.
Hey, there's a new bounty on the line.
Worth the trouble?
If you want to keep the lights on around here.
Where did we find this dipstick?
We'll handle this one.
On our own.
Not a chance.
Not that way! Hey!
In this video, we're going to show you how we did our own version of this effect. And that starts right now.
So to get started on our composite, we need to create two different background environments to key our actor into, in this case, AJ. Now you can choose any background that you'd like. For our project, we decided to build the scenes using a free, but very powerful open source 3D software called Blender, along with some 3D assets that we purchased from a company called Kitbash 3D. And for the record, we are not sponsored by either of these companies, but if you'd like to check out some of the resources that we use to create these backgrounds, links can be found in the description below.
So I'm gonna start with a brand new composition inside Adobe After Effects. I'm gonna drop in my footage and take my footage and drop it right into my timeline. So what we gotta do is we gotta key out this footage. And we're gonna do that by using an effect called Key Light. So go to my Effects and Presets tab and type in Key Light. And drag that onto my footage. Get my color picker, choose the nearest green to my subject, change from Final Result to Screen Matte. Under my Screen Matte settings, I'm gonna adjust the clip black and the clip white until I have a perfectly white silhouette of my subject. Looks pretty good. I'm gonna add a little bit of screen softness to that just to soften up those edges. Now that's pretty good. But I'm gonna clean up this footage using the Key Cleaner plugin. There we go. And it looks like there's still a little bit of green in my hair, so I'm gonna add an advanced spill suppressor. And boo hoo, that looks like some good clean footage. Don't know why I said that. So next, we're gonna set up our scene. So I'm gonna drop in the background that Casey created of the inside of the Bebop. And the first thing I am going to do is I'm going to go into my Effects and Presets tab, and I'm going to grab Lumetri Color and drop that onto my footage. And I'm going to color correct the footage to match the background. Just my exposure, my contrast, my saturation, my blacks, and my temperature and tint. Now once that's done, I'll pre-compose that and name it Shot Right. Perfect. So I'm going to go into my pre-composed layer, copy the main footage, and put it back over the pre-comp, and do the same thing and drag in the second background, the rooftop scene. And time to color correct. So I'll adjust the Lumetri color to where it matches the rooftop scene. I'll pre-compose that layer and name it Shot Left. At this point, actually, I realize that I have mislabeled these, so I will name that Shot Left, and then I'm gonna change it real quick. It's actually Shot Right. So change the first one to Shot Right and change the second one to Shot Left. There we go, perfect. So now I have two completely different shots. Now it's time to bring those shots together. So I'm gonna scroll through my timeline to the point where I interact with the frame and grab my shape tool, use the color picker to black, and draw that frame right above my hand. There we go, perfect. So now that I have the barrier between the two shots, I have to mask the two shots. So I'm gonna take my Shot Left and throw that mask all the way across. Now I'll go to my Shot Right and only mask that to the right-hand side of the layer. And I'll make sure that it's under the shape tool so that way we have a completely clean barrier between the first shot and the second shot. But now you would notice there is something wrong with this, my hand. We want my hand to pop out above the shape layer. So I'll go inside my pre-comp and I will copy that footage above the two pre-comped layers and then shorten it right before my hand hits the layer. So now I have a layer above and a layer below. Now I'm gonna move all the way to the right-hand side And we got to do that same thing. I'm going to go into my shot right. I'm going to copy the main shot from there and put it on top of the main layer. And we're going to do a jump cut. So right when my hand hits, we'll plop that layer so that way it looks like my hand is above the frame and interacting with it. So now we have to go in and keyframe the position of the frame. So you'll go into your position, add your keyframes, and as my hand moves, I'm going to move the shape frame right where my hand goes. So it looks like my hand is interacting with the frame. It's a little tedious, but boom. Now that looks great. It looks like I'm totally grabbing that frame. But now we notice that the background is not moving with it. So that's gonna be the next thing I have to do, is I have to animate what's called the mask path. So I'm gonna go to the mask path of that right shot, and I'm going to keyframe animate it to where it follows the exact same keyframes as the frame when it's moving in my hand. So as it moves back, I'll move it a little bit more. And as it moves forward, I will move it forward. So that way the mask of the shot stays right under the frame as it moves. Just like that. So now when I move the shot, it looks like I'm moving the frame itself. Now that we've done that, I want to animate the footage a little bit. So when the camera turns in, I'm going to slide my footage just a bit and give it a bit of a scaling animation. Now you don't have to do this, but we did it for hours. And look how nicely that moves right into place with the camera. So what we want to do now is we want to animate the aspect ratio. So I'm going to draw a shape, and I'm going to name that aspect ratio 1. And I'll copy that shape and bring it down to the bottom and name it aspect ratio 2. So I'm actually going to leave aspect ratio 2 above the footage and move aspect ratio 1 behind my footage. Now I'm going to animate the position of the aspect ratio. Now with the first aspect ratio behind my footage, it totally looks like my footage is popping out of the aspect ratio. That looks sweet. So our footage is looking pretty darn good right now. So now we want to get that sweet Cowboy Bebop silhouette effect. So I'm going to go up to my shape layer. I'm going to create a new shape. I'm going to make that red. I'm going to draw that all the way over the left-hand side of the footage and move it right above shot left. So it sits under my footage just like this. I'll rename that red. Now I'm gonna do the same thing with the blue and draw it right over shot right. And then place that right above my shot right comp. And we'll rename that blue. So now we have a blue and red shape just over our shots. So what we're going to do is we're going to animate the opacity on those. So we'll press T and we'll stick a keyframe at 100 and then a keyframe at 0. So that way the colors look like they fade right into the shot. Now what we're going to do is we're going to duplicate our main shot, and under Lumetri Color, we're actually going to set the exposure all the way down and the blacks all the way down. So that way I get a really nice black silhouette. I'm gonna hit T on my opacity, give it 100 and then a 0 in the same spot as the opacity fades on my red and blue layers. So that way the entire layer fades all at the same time. So far that's looking really, really good. But I still don't think it's Cowboy Bebop-y enough. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drop a grain layer over it. I have this sweet 16 millimeter grain that I'm gonna drop right over my footage. There we go. And I'm actually going to do an opacity fade on that in the same spot as my shapes. Trim it up, and I'm gonna turn that blending mode to multiply. So now that really has an old film noir Cowboy Bebop look to it. So last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate my main footage. So I'm gonna drag to where the shapes and the colors fade out, and I'm gonna give it an opacity of 20. And then I'm actually gonna move that just to the left of my footage to where it creates a shadow. And make sure that I fade that opacity just like I did with the shapes and the silhouette. Boom, that looks really good.
Now that we've gone through all the work of piecing together our composite, it's time to sit back and enjoy our final render. And real quick before we do, if you enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a like, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment to help us reach more VFX enthusiasts in the future. Now without any further ado, here is our version of the Cowboy Bebop camera frame effect.